Hey, welcome back, my friends. In today's video, I will show you how I painted this Dutch landscape painting here. Actually, in today's video, we're gonna do the upper part, the sky and the clouds, and in the next video, we're gonna do the windmill and the water part here. So we grab a set of colors and start to mix the first layer of color. But first, we need to oil out the surface here. Make sure it's not too thick, applied the oil. And then we build up the first layer and in parts, final layer for the cloud part. As you can see, we have a color that is pretty, very light. It's a titanium white with a bit lemon yellow and yeah, a hint of a bluish color to it. And yeah, we basically start with the brightest color on the right side, on the lower end of the painting, and gets darker the more we come to the left and upper part of the painting. And I also spare out the place for the clouds in this part here. I don't underpaint the whole thing. I basically paint around the location where the clouds will later on be located. And then I also start to underpaint the middle and the greens here. And then I mix another set of colors for the water part. It's a grayish color. And on the very front part, we have this kind of a blackish color. And then I let it dry. I think it took quite a while, 10 days or so, to really get dry. And then of course you have to get rid of the dust that started to collect on the painting. And then I mix the final set of colors for the cloud parts. Yeah, on the left part we have, I don't know how they are called, very small, dotish-like clouds that I put on in a very easy way, in a very simple technique. Basically, yeah, just slapping on the color and rubbing it into the dry background. Yeah, detail shot of this technique or way of building up those details here. You can get them a bit more to the foreground when you add a bit more color and less, a bit more into the background by adding less color. So it's basically steered by the amount of color that you put on, and then you basically rub the color into the background. It blends in more or less. I'm already starting to use different colors here. These brownish colors that we have later on in the cloud parts. And in some parts I get already a bit more whitish. A bit further down the road we start to build up the very darkish parts of this body of cloud on the right side. And I spent ages on blending it into the background. Especially the edges of the clouds. And it's something that I see people do wrong very often. They just think clouds have to be like cut out, and this is wrong. Clouds are in most of the time, most of the places, very often melting into the background color. And it doesn't appear to be right when you do it. Or you think the clouds need to stand out, but this is the wrong thinking. Of course, you have parts where the clouds really stand out of the background color. But as you can see here, in the left part of this part of the body of clouds here, we have the clouds really fading into the background, and this is something that people very often get wrong. And therefore the clouds of those people don't really look realistic, and they don't connect with the background, and this is something very, very essential. Yeah, so I build up the volume of this part here. And yeah, we have lighter parts where the sun hits them, more or less, and I establish the light up areas first, and then I build up the volume that we have in those areas where the cloud is thicker. I mean, this lighter bluish color here represents the background, the color of the sky in the back. And the darker areas represent basically the thick body of the cloud, where the cloud is very thick and dense. And basically it's not just painting like an apple, more or less. I'm building up from the lighter areas to the darker areas. And we don't have just the bluish color, we have this very light color in the front. And there's this reddish color in all shapes and sizes and variations of color itself. And this reddish color basically also melts into the background color and into this very darkish, grayish color here. With this thinking, you build up clouds that have volume, that look realistic. Now to the lower end here, basically the same, more or less, lighter colors on the area where the sun hits. But again, you need to have variations, and you have to toy around with the color and to get in the volume and the randomness that a cloud requires of this kind here. Same for the upper part here, this bit reddish color that I dry brush into the dry background color. And from this part on, I build up the volume of those clouds. Again, poking in holes through the cloud, this light blue color here basically represents holes that we have in the cloud. Parts where the background color, where the sky is shining through. And again, blending, as you can see, a lot of really soft transitions between the colors, and especially from the background color to the cloud color, more or less, in the foreground. This is a very essential part of this, of painting clouds in a realistic way, and especially on this very kind of difficult light situation here that we have. Then we build up the clouds on the lower end. Again, lots of dry brushing, adding details here and there over the still wet layer of color we put on before. And this was not an easy thing to build up those colors and those transitions and the volume. It took me quite a while to get through. Here we are building up the most dense part, I think. We have a lot of distance that we have to communicate, and darker areas, and slap on those colors side by side and try to really get a nice transition and get in those single detail parts where we have the light hitting areas of the cloud being a bit lighter, letting them fade out into the bluish color, a very dark purplish bluish color from the big cloud body here. And this was a process that took me, as I said before, quite a while, but I think it came out not too bad, actually. I'm building up the volume, building up the areas where we have the sun hitting. But as we communicate a bit more of the far away distance, a bit further away from the sun, we go a bit darker on this areas where the cloud is hit by the sun. I see again lots of color variations, even in this bluish, purplish color here. Lots of variations and going back and reworking areas where I think we need to add a bit more volume, a bit more 3D, a bit more layers of the cloud. And of course, blending. Have a nice transition between those colors. Yeah, and we're done. So that's it for today, but make sure you check back for the second part of this video here, the part where we paint the mill and the water, coming next week.